Hey guys, in the last couple weeks we have been talking a lot about the weather and a lot about precipitation in particular. Remember that precipitation has anything to do with what comes from the clouds, such as rain, snow, sleet, or hail. And so we've been talking a lot about those in the past couple weeks that we've been either at school or under the quarantine time here at home. So today, I want you to watch this video. You should have already, if not, filled out your Flipgrid video describing the weather for today all the way through Friday. So make sure you go to weather.com and look up those dates and then give me the Flipgrid. Show me through your Flipgrid how you are the weather person. So today's lesson, we are just going to read a story and then answer a few questions. So the story that I brought today is called Down Comes the Rain. Okay, and so probably in your view, it's backwards just because that's just how it has to be because it's on the mode of like the flip camera view. And so if that's backwards to you, I'm very sorry. We're going to read it anyway. All right. So Down Comes the Rain by Franklin M. Branly, illustrated by James Graham Hale. Okay. There's the first picture. It says, rain comes from clouds. It comes from big clouds and little clouds. We kind of know that already. It comes from black clouds, white clouds, and gray clouds. Remember what kind of clouds are the gray clouds? You guys remember what those are called? Do you guys remember what the black storm thunderclouds are called? Extra bonus points for that. All clouds, big ones and little ones, gray ones and white ones, are made of billions of tiny drops of water. The drops are called droplets because they are so small. If this is the size of a drop of water, a droplet would be just a tiny speck, even smaller than this one. And so there's a little speck right there. I see that. Water droplets come from water vapor. Water vapor is a gas. And this guy over here, he says, there's always water vapor in the air, but you can't see it. She says, can't smell it. And this one says, and you can't feel it. So they're all talking about the way they're using their senses to talk about water vapor. Look at the dog. Silly. Water vapor is made when water evaporates. That means the water changes from a liquid to a gas. So, you can see in this picture. You guys see the picture here? The girl. She says, in the morning, put a teaspoon of water in the saucer. And then by that night, it may have evaporated into the air. Well, that'd be a cool experiment to do at home while you're quarantined and you're not supposed to leave your house. That would be a fun experiment. So put a teaspoon of water in a saucer or a plate of some sort, and then by the night, see if it's still there. All right. Next it says, when wet clothes hang on the clothesline, the water in them evaporates. The heat from the sun changes the water drops and droplets into water vapor. Just like the heat from the stove changes water in the kettle to change water in the kettle to change water vapor. If you heat it long enough, all the water boils away. The water vapor goes into the air. We've talked about that before as well in our science class, how water vapor, and whenever you start to boil it, it starts to go up into the air and disappears. into a gas. Most of the water vapor in the air comes from lakes, rivers, and oceans. It comes from the leaves of plants and from the wet ground. Heat from the sun causes the water to evaporate. The water changes from a liquid to a gas, and the water vapor goes into the air. And so this is just like the water cycle that we have already tested on and already talked a lot about it. Shows how it's going up into the air, comes from the rivers and the lakes, and then it changes from a liquid to a gas. So let's see what else it says. When you breathe out, you put water vapor into the air. Usually you cannot see the water vapor, but it is there. So this girl, she's in the snow. You guys see her? She says, sometimes if it's cold, you can see your breath. That's because the water vapor condenses. It changes from a gas to a little cloud. And we talked a lot about condensation as well. Condensation. When cows, horses, and dogs and cats breathe out, they put water vapor into the air too. On a cold day, the water vapor changes to droplets and makes little clouds that you can see. There's the horse and the dog. And they also have water vapor that comes out when it's cold. You ever see your breath when it's really cold outside? That's what it's talking about. All right, so you can make water vapor change to water. So here's another experiment you guys can do while you're at home. Put a lot of ice into a glass of water. As the glass gets colder, the outside of the glass gets wet. Okay, so she's putting all that ice and then puts the water into it. Okay, and so you can see on the outside what happens to it. Water vapor in the air is condensing on the glass. There may be so much condensation that the glass drips. Sometimes the glass stays dry. That means there is not much water vapor in the air. So maybe, so a lot of times you'll see this in the summertime because it is so hot outside and that cold and hot air that we talked about meet, and that's when that condensation builds up on the side of your glass. All right, let's see what this one, what the hot air balloon says. The air holds the water vapor. Breezes carry it from one place to another. Much of the vapor moves up and away from the earth. Air above the earth is always cold. The higher you go, the colder it gets. When the air gets cold enough, the water vapor in it condenses. The vapor changes from water droplets. The water droplets make clouds. We did a whole section over clouds as well, didn't we? When clouds are thin and wispy, they are holding only a little water. When clouds are thick and dark, they are holding much more water. And when they're cold, they're dark like that, what's coming? What do you think is coming? Probably a thunderstorm, right? A single droplet is so small you cannot see it, but you can see a cloud. That's because there are millions and millions and millions of water droplets in a cloud. So all these kids are in the air balloon, and they say, inside the cloud, droplets join together to make drops. When clouds can no longer hold them, the drops fall to the earth. The sky is full of them, and they fall through the air and splatter on the ground. Look, the dog even has a saying. They are raindrops. Sometimes there are only a few raindrops that fall slowly. It is drizzling, okay? Sometimes just a little bit of fall at a time. It's just, I think it was doing that yesterday. It had a little bit of drizzle in the air. And then sometimes there are lots of big drops that fall very fast. Now it is pouring. Okay, so those are big ones. That's when it rains really hard outside. And it's pouring rain. That means that cloud was full of them. Sometimes the drops and clouds freeze. These raindrops become ice drops. This can happen even on a hot summer day. Some clouds may be higher than most airplanes ever go. The higher the clouds, the colder they are. So the higher, the further up they get, the colder they are. That's because the clouds and the water droplets are high above the earth. Many clouds are so high that it is freezing cold. You can see that there. The airplane, so some of those clouds are even above the airplane. It's really cold up there. In these high, cold clouds, water vapor changes to droplets. The droplets change to drops. The drops freeze into ice. So this guy over here says, inside the cloud, these tiny bits of ice start to fall. And this guy over here says, but they don't always fall out of the cloud. Instead, they may be carried upward by air that is moving away from Earth. Okay, so that's something we really haven't talked about. So let's look at this chart. So here is freezing cold. And so there's water vapor that changes into droplets. And then water drops change into ice drops. And then from Earth, everything's kind of moving up towards it. And so sometimes we don't have those ice drops because the air is moving away. You see that? As they are carried upward, more water collects on the tiny bits of ice. When the water freezes, the drops of ice have another layer on them. The ice drops are now heavier, so once more they fall toward the earth. But air moving away from the earth may carry the ice drops upward again. Higher and higher they go. And another layer of ice freezes onto them. The ice drops get heavier and heavier. They get so heavy that the air cannot hold them any longer. So the ice drops fall to the earth. It's raining ice. And then there's this little guy that says, yikes. Do you see? The earth is down here, and so it just gets so heavy that it can't hold it anymore. So it starts raining ice, which is otherwise known as, anybody know? We're going to find out. So over here, you have a group of friends, and they all sing a little part. It says, the ice drops are called hailstones. Okay, we know that. They may be the size of your fingernail, or they may be as big as golf balls or even bigger. That's so crazy. A couple weeks ago, we had a really bad storm, and my parents had softball-size hail at their farm. And they sent me a picture. It was crazy how big they were. And so sometimes hail can be really scary, so you have to be really careful. And they have a newspaper article that says, in 1970, hailstones as big as softballs fell on Kansas. Fields of corn were flattened by the hailstorm. Okay? So that's kind of what just happened to my parents' hometown. A lot of them got affected by the hail. Hailstones are not stones. They are pieces of ice. So when it hails, go inside so you're not hit on the head. When it stops hailing, go outside and pick up a hailstone. Break it in two, and you will see the layers of ice. Okay, so all these guys are protecting their heads. They're ready. So don't be outside when it's hailing. You want to be inside, otherwise you'll hurt yourself. Okay. And then after it's over, you can go outside and pick up a piece. And you will see what's inside. Water in the clouds make hail. Water in the clouds make rain. When it stops raining or hailing, the sun comes out. Once more, water evaporates. So we're back at the beginning. After it rains, then it goes back, hits the ground, and goes back up into the air. Just like we talked about in the water cycle. It evaporates from lakes, rivers, and oceans. It evaporates from cows and horses, from cats and dogs. It evaporates from leaves of plants and from the wet ground, and from you and me. So it evaporates from all of us. The water changes to water vapor. It's carried up and away from the earth where the air is cool or even freezing. When the water vapor cools, it condenses. The water vapor changes to water droplets, and altogether the droplets make clouds. Water droplets join together to make water drops. The drops fall to the earth from the clouds. See that? And then, once more, it's raining. So you can see the rain coming out of the window there. The end. All right, so that's Down Comes the Rain. I hope you guys enjoyed that book. Hopefully, we will be able to read. I have another book ready to go, but hopefully I'll be able to see you guys and we can read it together in person. I will have some questions ready for you at the end of this video. So you'll want to go down to your Google Docs on the very bottom there, and there will be some questions and answers ready for you to answer. So you want to open up a new doc and then answer the questions. There'll be three questions. Answer them in a complete sentence and then reshare it with me so I can see your answers, okay? All right, see you guys later.